Medicaid and CHIP Financial System, or MACFin, is an integrated system that enables the federal portion of funding for state Medicaid and CHIP programs. MACFin improves on the Medicaid budget and expenditure system by introducing additional reporting capabilities, streamlining previously manual processes, offering documentation upload, and improving overall user experience. MACFin features, workflows, and automation make it easier for states, territories, and the federal government to share and use data about budget estimates, medical assistance and administrative grant awards, program expenditures, CHIP allotments, disproportionate share hospital allotments, and upper payment limits.
How can I access MACFin to report my state or territory's Medicaid and CHIP financial data?
Getting access to MACFin is a four-part process. First, you must have an account with the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services Enterprise portal at portal.cms.gov. Second, you must request basic access to MACFin. Third, you must set up your MACFin account. And finally, you must request access to the MACFin modules you need for your work.
That sounds like a lot. What if I need help?
It may sound complicated, but we'll cover the basics of each part of the process. If you need help, there is an instruction manual with more information, and you can always contact the MACFin help desk if you get stuck.
Okay, so first I need an account for the CMS Enterprise Portal?
Yes, you need an account for the Enterprise Portal on the web at portal.cms.gov to access MACFin. If the portal is new to you, start by clicking the New User Registration button. If you already have a CMS Enterprise Portal account, you can use it to request access to MACFin after you log into the portal. You don't need to create a new Enterprise Portal account. But be careful, if you log into the portal with an account for the CMS Enterprise User Administration, or EUA system, you won't be able to request access to MACFin. You'll need to sign out of the portal and start all over again at portal.cms.gov.
How can I tell the difference between an EUA account login and a portal account login?
One way to tell the difference between EUA and portal account logins is that EUA logins always have four-character user IDs.
Okay, so if I don't already have a portal account, what happens after I click the New User Registration button?
The Select Your Application screen will open, where you must select MACFin from the drop-down list and read the terms and conditions for access. You must agree to the terms and conditions by clicking the checkbox to continue your registration. You will then use three screens to enter and confirm the information CMS needs to create your portal account. The first screen is where you'll provide personal and contact information CMS will use to confirm your identity and communicate with you about your portal account. If you work for a state or territory, be sure to use your government email address. Using another email address may delay your MACFin access request. The next screen is for creating your portal user ID, password, and challenge questions. The last screen is where you can double-check your registration information, make corrections if you need to, and submit your information to complete CMS Enterprise Portal registration.
How will I know CMS received my registration request and whether it is approved?
When you submit your information, a message will appear on the screen confirming your registration is complete. You also will receive an email message confirming your registration at the address you provided.
Great! Now I can log into my portal account and start using MACFin.
Not yet! You may need to wait for up to 30 minutes for your portal account to be activated, and then you must log in and request MACFin access. This is all part of the four-part process I mentioned.
Oh, right. So how do I request basic MACFin access?
You can request basic MACFin access by using your user ID and password to log into the CMS Enterprise Portal at portal.cms.gov. The first time you log in, you will see a message instructing you to register for multi-factor authentication. Multi-factor authentication makes your account more secure by requiring you to enter a code sent to your email address or mobile device when you log in. After you register for multi-factor authentication, the system will open your My Portal screen, where you can request access to MACFin. To start your MACFin access request, click the Add Application button. This will open the Request Application Access screen, which shows a list of steps you must complete to finish your MACFin access request. Step 1. Select Medicaid and CHIP Financial System, MACFin, from the application drop-down list, then click the Next button. Step 2. Select MACFin End User at the bottom of the Select a Role drop-down list.
What about those other roles?
The other roles on the list are for internal CMS use only. If you select anything except MACFin End User, your MACFin access request will be rejected.
Okay, what next?
Click the Next button and you'll advance to Step 3, Complete Identity Verification. This step has four sub-steps that will appear in a pop-up window. Click the Launch button to open the pop-up window and begin the identity verification sub-steps, which are required to protect your privacy and MACFin system security. The first sub-step displays an overview of identity verification. This overview explains that CMS will confirm your identity with Experian, a consumer credit reporting company that provides identity verification services. Experian will verify your identity with information from your credit report. This service is free to you and won't affect your credit score. Read this overview carefully and click the Next button to continue to the second identity verification sub-step, Accept Terms and Conditions. Read the terms and conditions carefully and click the I Agree checkbox. Then click the Next button to continue to the third identity verification sub-step, Enter Your Information. Even though this sub-step asks you to enter your home address and phone number, be sure to enter the same government email address you used for your portal account. Other email addresses may delay your MACFin access request. When you're done entering and double-checking your information, click the checkbox. Then click the Next button to continue to the final identity verification sub-step, Verify Your Identity. To complete this sub-step, you must answer several multiple-choice questions based on information from your Experian credit report. When you're done answering these questions, click the Next button to close the identity verification pop-up window. You will see a message confirming you have completed identity verification.
Great. Can I submit my basic MACFin access request now?
Not yet. There are two more steps to go before your basic MACFin access request is complete. Click the Next button to exit the sub-steps and continue to step 4, Enter Business Contact Information. This step asks you about your employer. Enter your employer's name and contact information, then click the Next button to continue to step 5, Reason for Request. This step asks you to describe why you need access to MACFin. You'll need to enter your reason again during parts 3 and 4 of the MACFin access request process, so it's a good idea to keep a copy handy so you can reuse it later.
Got it. Keep a copy of my reason for later so I can use it again. But what should my reason include?
At a minimum, your reason should include a brief description of your job function and employer, as well as the work you do related to Medicaid and CHIP budgets or expenditures.
Okay. Can you give me an example or two?
Sure. Here are some that might be helpful. Example 1. I am an analyst with the state of Illinois and need to upload UPL submissions for review. Example 2. I am a supervisor in the Kentucky Medicaid office. I certify all budget, CMS 37, CMS 21B, and expenditure, CMS 64, CMS 21, submissions for Kentucky. I also review and certify IBNRS submissions.
Thanks. What should I do next?
Next, enter the reason for your request and click the Submit button to send your request to CMS for approval. You'll see a confirmation message acknowledging your request is successfully submitted. This message also includes a tracking number for your request and information about how to access MACFin after your request is approved. You'll also receive an email message that includes this information when your request is processed. When you are finished reading the confirmation message, click the OK button to complete part 2 of the MACFin access request process.
How long will it take for my request to be approved?
It may take up to a day for CMS to approve your access request. After that, you'll be ready to complete part 3.
So, what do I need to know about part 3?
After you receive email confirmation that your basic MACFin access request is approved, log into the CMS Enterprise portal at portal.cms.gov. The system will take you to your My Portal screen where you can complete the third part of your MACFin access request, User Setup. Click the Medicaid and CHIP Financial System, MACFin, tile. This will open the MACFin User Setup screen. Whether you work for a state or a territory, select State from the User Type drop-down list and select the name of your state or territory from the State drop-down list. Then, describe how you plan to use MACFin in the Reason field. If you kept a copy of the reason you used earlier to request basic MACFin access, you can reuse it now. At a minimum, your reason should include a brief description of your job function and employer, as well as the work you do related to Medicaid and CHIP budgets or expenditures. Next, click the Submit for Review button to send your user setup request to CMS for approval. You will receive an email confirming CMS has received your request and another when your request is approved. There's only one more part of the process to go before you can start using MACFin.
The last part is getting access to the MACFin modules I need for my work, right?
That's right. After you receive email confirmation that your user setup request is approved, log into the CMS Enterprise Portal once more at portal.cms.gov. The system will take you to your My Portal screen where you can access MACFin. Click the Medicaid and CHIP Financial System, MACFin, tile to open MACFin, and then click the My MACFin Profile button to open the My Profile screen. Click the Request Role button on this screen to open the Request Role pop-up window where you can request access to a MACFin module you need for your work. To start your request, select the module you need from the module drop-down list. Next, select the role that applies to you from the role drop-down list. Then, enter or paste the reason for your request in the Reason field. And finally, click the Request button to submit your module access request and return to the My Profile screen.
What if I need access to more than one module?
You can only request access to one module at a time, but you can use the Request Role button as many times as you need to request access to other modules. And that's it. The next time you sign into MACFin after you receive email confirmation that your module access is approved, you'll see the module in the MACFin menu bar and can start using it.
Thanks. Can you remind me what to do if I have questions about completing any part of my MACFin access request?
Sure. If you have questions, have difficulty completing your access request, or would like a copy of the MACFin Access User Guide, contact the MACFin Help Desk by email or by calling toll-free 1-833-879-6075. We're here to help.